Hi, my name is Charles from rcbenchmark.com. Obtaining motor and propeller data is essential if you want to improve the range and performance of your designs. Today, I'm going to show you how to characterize a motor and a propeller. I'll be testing the NTM Prop Dry 3530 brushless motor with a Quantum 13-4 carbon fiber prop. I will also be using the RC Benchmark Dynamometer to perform the characterization. So first I install the ESC, connect the power, the signal, and then I install the motor and the propeller. This device measures thrust using this load cell, and the torque is measured using a pivot system. The power from the battery goes through the dynamometer's circuit, which will measure both the voltage and the current. We also record the motor's speed using this simple RPM probe. All of these properties will be recorded by the dynamometer's software. Before we ran this test, I calibrated the equipment using the calibration hardware, and I teared the load cell's readings. We are currently reading zero thrust and zero torque. The complete test is run from the manual control tab. We manually record the values of all the sensors using this take sample button. For the test, we increase the throttle in small increments. We allow some time for the motor to settle and then take another sample. This process can also be done automatically by the software in the automatic control tab. Here's the generated CSV file. We see that it has all the readings, such as voltage, current, torque, thrust, etc. But we also see that the dynamometer automatically calculated a few properties for you, like the motor efficiency and propeller efficiency. You can directly make plots using a software such as Excel or MATLAB for this data. For example, here's a plot of the propeller's thrust and efficiency versus RPM. So that's it. You can compare this motor and propeller to other ones and use the result of your analysis to improve the performance of your quadcopter, robot, or machine. There's more analysis that can be done on the motor, so watch out for our next video. If you want to see a written tutorial, look at the link below. Thanks and see you next time.